gives him the option of moving Marlowe into the top six. Tierney back, Vlasic shooting, scores through the screen, and it beats Rene. And the Sharks strike first. You mentioned Tierney. He's a key part on this goal. They're able to cause a turnover in the neutral zone. Then once they got it in to the offensive zone, they kept the pressure on. That was a high rising shot. I believe the coaches for Nashville want this looked at to see if it wasn't tipped above the crossbar. But here's all the hard work. Here comes the shot from the point. Did it get deflected on the way in, or did it just dip? Here it is again.
Is it Tierney's stick?
Tierney's stick. Tierney is 50 in white. Let's see where he tips it. Hard to tell there. His stick, to be legal, has to be below the cross.
Contact is below the level of the crossbar. Therefore, the ball on the ice stands. We have a good goal.
Talked about that this morning, that there was going to be some duress early, and they're going to have to show composure. Here's a loose puck in front. Shot in front. Really down, and they score. And it's Chris Tierney again. And Rene out to argue as he felt he may have been bumped in the crease.
Well, he had trouble with the first shot. The first shot came from the point. Brent Burns took it. Rene thought he had it and then lost it. And then the Sharks just attacked the net. Here comes the shot. He thinks he has it. He doesn't. One more chance. He tries to get back the over the other way. And Tierney puts that one in as well. The aggressiveness of the Sharks. That attempted second shot actually deflected off one of the Nashville players. You'll see the deflection coming up here. And so it doesn't get to Rene. He has to try and scramble to go across the other way. And Tierney is there for the 2-0 lead.
Last game here, triple overtime. Chris Tierney did not have a shot on goal. He has two tonight and a pair of goals to give San Jose the lead. Check there just outside the line. Neal back in. James Neal unable to control, but following up a chance, and his backhander in, scores. Roman Josi on the backhand.
The Sharks were caught on a line change and a steal of the puck in the neutral zone. Those two things combined. Here comes Neal. There you see the late man coming in, and they turn it into this. What a move by Josi to just throw it in front of the net. And Mike Fisher is there also. I believe Josi will get credit for it, but it all starts with the turnover, and this line strikes again for the Nashville Predators.
That puck goes in almost slow motion. Up off, looks like Hurdle, off Jones, and Josi, who had 36 shots in the playoffs without a goal, have their legs now. Ekholm moves in, plays behind the net. Bad angle shot, and Martin Jones has got that.
Do they ever have their legs now? They listen to the coach about getting the puck in deep, going after it, and causing some issues. They've done that, the defense involved. Good puck control, good puck movement. And Jones has to come up with a save there. Holding onto the puck and making plays, and that's Ryan Johansson who has the final shot before Jones is able to hold on for a whistle.
Little Trent working in front, and that's stopped by Jones. Johansson with such reach, he had a shooting area there, and the backhand scores! Johansson's tied it!
Johansson said before the game, this is the one that he's got to be better. How about this? He's got one here. He's got a chance to walk in front. Doesn't realize it, but takes the shot anyway. And then the aggressiveness of Nashville keeps the play alive. And there's that beautiful move, little fake shot. Justin Braun is an outstanding defensive defenseman. And he gets beat on that move by Johansson, and underneath the stick And this place has erupted as Johansson has come back to tie it. Battles, puck comes free, and a good reach there by Ellis to hold the zone again. Fisher quickly in front, it comes, and Martin Jones has the stop off Colin Wilson, who looks skyward. Ryan Ellis is having a heck of a period, keeping the play alive that led to that last shot by Wilson. Keeps it in the zone, they go back to work. Again, the intact mentality of the Nashville Predators, getting the puck, getting players moving to the net.
Wall. Now Couture picks a puck up at center. He'll go to the attack, along with Marleau. Stopped by Rene. On a good look by Patrick Marleau from point blank range. In on the draw for the Predators, Pavelski wins it. And here is Burns, fires! Oh, Rene the stop. And you saw him with a little shoulder check to make sure it hadn't squeaked by him.
Right off the faceoff, the Sharks win it. Gostad will now go out there. Joe Pavelski with the faceoff win. One pass, one shot, good save. And right after that, Paul Gostad goes off the bench to take this faceoff against Joe Thornton.
Pavelski behind the net, Thornton up top. Burns, Couture, shot, scores! Logan Couture, power play goal! Sharks have the lead.
And on the play, Pekka Rinne was down on the ice. And it might have been his own player, a little collision in front. There was a little bit of an argument. But you'll see Rinne, who tried to move over, was down on the ice, so there was a wide open net. Watch in front. Rinne moves over. Boy, he just kind of fell down. Pavelski was there. He reached out and just looked like he lost his balance.
Yeah,
more than anything. And then the quick shot to almost a wide open net. Turns out to be a power play goal. So you see Rinne well out of the net and outside the crease. He reaches out and makes contact with Joe Pavelski.
How about Logan Couture, fifth goal of this series, sixth overall.
Age blew by both of those defenders.
Here's Boteto in. He gets upended. Pass across. Neal in front. Scores! Game tied again! Colin Wilson!
Boteto gets knocked down, and then how about the pass from Neal to Wilson? They were looking for a penalty, and then this beautiful pass that quickly. Boy, oh boy, do they have magic together. This place was quiet for a moment after the go-ahead goal. Not anymore. What a play.
Mike Ribeiro has his first point of this series. In support there, looking to see if that puck comes loose. It does, and it comes to Neal in front. Big stop, rebound, and that doesn't go.
And then he has one more crack at it. How about this move? Once, and then this one off the side of the net with a little bit of room on the short side. He just can't be stopped. The size, the hands.
Around Salamaki on this near side. He'll flip it through center. Bouncing puck in, onto it. Arvidsson scores! Seventh heaven in Nashville, Victor Arvidsson with his first ever Stanley Cup playoff goal. Joey's been all over it in this series with speed, with chances, and finally, at the most important time, he breaks through.
It was such an innocent-looking play. Melker Carlson misplays it. Arvidsson, with his speed, picks it up, and that quickly on the backhand. Here comes again, innocent-looking play. Carlson can't handle it. Arvidsson can, and then what a finish. How about this backhand shot? Wow! Just barely off the arm of Martin Jones. And Arvidsson sends it to a game seven.
The pinch reaction a little better executed than the triple overtime one.